Before there was Skylab, there was Salyut, the first functional orbital space station. First launched in April of 1971, during the time when Apollo was still flying to the moon. Salyut was designed for a crew of three, ferried to and from the station in the Soyuz spacecraft. When the first crew in Soyuz 10 failed to dock that month, Soyuz 11 became the only crew to man it, arriving in June for a 23-day stay. These men became national heroes in Russia, but unfortunately would not survive to receive a hero's welcome, suffocating on re-entry when a valve broke open while still outside the atmosphere. Salyut 1 would re-enter the atmosphere in October of that year. The second Salyut was not actually a Salyut at all, but a military Almaz station, disguised under the Salyut name. Salyut 2 was launched 2 years after Salyut 1, yet would not receive any crews. When the third stage of the proton booster exploded, debris punctured the station, and it achieved total failure 13 days later. The following month, another Almaz was launched, given the name Salyut 3. Just like the first Salyut, it would only receive one crew, Soyuz 14, for a 15-day stay that month. In August, Soyuz 15 failed to dock due to a malfunctioning rendezvous system, and therefore would not receive any more crews before it was deorbited in January of 1975. The Almaz maintained an extremely low orbit and kept a constant observational position relative to the Earth, which consumed fuel rapidly, and this rapid fuel depletion is what contributed to its short lifespan. A month before, Russia returned to its civilian DOS design for Salyut 4, launching in December of 1974. Much the same as Salyut 1, the primary visual difference was, of course, the larger solar panels in the recurring T-shaped pattern. Here we see the station docked with a Soyuz spacecraft, but this particular Soyuz is the TMA variant currently in service today, unlike the Soyuz 7T, which was in service at the time. Exceeding the two previous stations, Salyut 4 would receive two successful crews, Soyuz 17 in January for a 29-day stay, and 4 months later Soyuz 18 for a period of 62 days, not beating Skylab, but an endurance record for Russia at the time. It should also be noted that the Soyuz 18 crew were present on the station during the historic joint mission of the Apollo-Soyuz test project. Salyut 4 would remain alone from August 1975 to February of 1977, when she would make her fiery re-entry. The following station of Salyut 5 would return to the military Almaz design seen earlier, virtually a clone copy of Salyut 3, yet once again faltering to its low altitude and docking malfunctions. Here is where Russia truly began to shine, with the most innovative orbital station since Skylab. Salyut 6, launching in September 1977. What makes Salyut 6 special is the second docking port. While Skylab had two docking ports as well, this one was equipped for the transfer of fuel, oxygen, water, and consumables. The first station designed to be refueled in orbit. Here, we see Salyut 6 docked with the Soyuz manned spacecraft at the nose, and an unmanned Progress freight truck in the back. The Progress is still in service today, ferrying supplies to the International Space Station. Salyut 6 would receive 18 crews during its span of just under 5 years, the first crew on Soyuz 26 breaking Skylab's record with a 96-day stay. That record broken again 3 more times until finally setting an endurance record of 184 days uninterrupted. Salyut 6 was the catalyst that would make the upcoming Mir program come to fruition. Unfortunately, not quite yet. With delays to the Mir program, Russia decided to utilize the backup module for Salyut 6, launching in April of 1982. As 6's backup module, Salyut 7 was identical in capability internally. However, some improvements externally improved its capabilities. most notably its solar wings, adapted for secondary panels, and the enlarged docking port at the nose, to allow for docking with the TKS spacecraft as we see here. The Transportni Korabl Snabzhenia, or Transport Supply Spacecraft, was similar to the Progress as it was built to ferry equipment up to the station, but unlike Progress, it was built to be both manned and unmanned, with the VA spacecraft module similar to an Apollo command module, but smaller, capable of re-entering the atmosphere safely. The TKS would form the basis of several future space station modules, including Zarya, the first module of the International Space Station. During its operational lifespan of 4 years, Salyut 7 would receive 10 crews, its first breaking Salyut 6's record with a 211-day stay, that record broken in February 1984, with Soyuz T-10's crew staying for 236 days, nearly 8 full months uninterrupted. The final crew would arrive in March of 1986 aboard Soyuz T-15, staying aboard Salyut for 50 days, during that time removing components, experiments, and supplies, ferrying them over to the newly launched core module of Mir. Salyut 7 would remain alone for another 4 years. Originally, they'd planned to revisit Salyut 7 with a TKS crew, and even visit with a new Buran space shuttle, but those plans would not come to pass. Salyut and TKS-4 would remain together, both deorbiting in February 1991. Spanning 20 years, Salyut revolutionized the art of working and living in space, and would serve as the cornerstone for all that would follow. An unfortunately unsung and forgotten hero of space history.